wanna come back to those times where all movies were so scary. A blood red light, we're creatures of the night. I wanna come back to those times and kiss the free screen queen. I wanna come back to those nights, my horror night.
Welcome to the last video store. I'm your host, Bud Haddonfield, and today we're gonna be clowning around. I figured with the release of Terrifier 3, I went to see it today. It wasn't so bad. I'm going to give a little mini review later on in this episode, but I figured to talk about 10 really good clown movies. And what I consider clown movies is, number one, they got to have a clown in it. And number two, it has to kill at least one person. So, list, no particular order, 10 good clown movies.
Krusty the Clown is back on the air!
Breakfast! I'm hungry!
I'll kill you all! I'll drive you crazy and I'll kill you all! I'm every nightmare you ever had. I am your worst dream come true. I'm everything you ever were afraid of. I said I'm going to kill you. You, Homer Simpson!
Oh, yeah? With what?
So, the first movie on our list is going to be Clown. It was a movie directed by John Watts from the early to mid-2010s. It wasn't a bad little movie. It was a whole lot of fun. I really enjoyed it when it first came out. It's about a guy who is his kid's birthday, and he puts on this clown gear that he finds in the trunk, but it's not no ordinary clown stuff. It turns him into an ancient clown demon. And it's cool. I believe it was a short by Eli Roth, and they turned it into a full-length feature film.
There's Daddy. He's gonna miss the clown.
There was a little bit of a goof up.
There's no clown coming.
Who double books a clown?
I thought you had a backup.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Perfect.
Mr. Clown!
Dad, hurry, I'm gonna be late!
I physically cannot get it off. It's suffocating.
One. Two.
Daddy?
Oh, Jack, sweetie, let's get you to bed.
That's not Daddy.
I can feel myself changing. It's not a costume. It's skin of a demon. It lured five children into its tail. One child forevermore. A winter.
I want to see my number one birthday boy.
Don't go up there.
So the next movie on our list is going to be one from 2006, and it's going to be Drive Through. This movie, also a whole lot of fun, and you're going to get a whole lot of fun because, you know, it's clown, it's funny, it's all kind of cool stuff. The late Morgan Spurlock, I believe, was his name, the guy who did the McDonald's show. He was in this movie, and it's about this weird little clown going around killing people, and it has something to do with this little drive-in restaurant. This one's a whole lot of fun, very cheesy, very enjoyable drive-through. This one's still in print on DVD. It never got a Blu-ray release from what I remember, but you can also find it on Amazon Prime streaming on one of the channels.
What would you like to order today? Do you want something meaty?
Did someone say pork?
Do you want it bloody? Would you like fries with that?
I'm on the scene
of yet another grisly murder.
You don't believe anything I've told you. It was a 7-foot clown chasing me with a meat cleaver.
Why would someone dressed as Horny the Clown want to hurt your children?
I am the one person who might be able to stop him.
Order up a slice of horror. Drive through.
Fast food kills.
So the next movie, before there was any Terrifier or The Clown, there was this fun little movie called 100 Tears, and it is an absolute gore fest. This one was directed by Marcus Koch. Not much that I could say if you haven't seen this movie. It's literally just this overweight clown going up killing people in all kind of gory fashion. This one's cool, not for the squeamish, but very enjoyable. So 100 Tears.
Don't you touch her! Don't you touch her!
Tell you what, it's not.
We're all gonna be in trouble. Okay? This just means there's a serial killer.
What do you mean? You're free!
It's the 7th case we've had just like this one. We had one the other day, and now 2 tonight.
Just go
with me. Alright. I'll go with you. We have 1 week to get a cover story to the Midnight Star.
No, let me stop!
We're looking for some information on a clown.
What are you, FBI?
This guy's been killing for 20 years. Lays waste to an entire halfway house. And nobody knows anything. I don't get it. What's the deal?
Gertie the clown!
What the hell are you talking about?
Okay, the teardrop killer?
He's a circus clown.
Yes, yes. Okay, you know, we don't have time. I know this sounds crazy, but we need to get out of here.
God damn it, Drago. 20 years we've kept Johnny Law out of our business. Justice was done. Eye for an eye. Carney Law.
He's a killer. What? He's killing people.
Continuing with Killjoy, I've always loved Full Moon Features. Full Moon Features movies, they have one of the coolest catalogs out there. And one of their earlier films, I'll say early films, 2000s, and it was Killjoy. I only have it in this 3-pack right here that has the first three, and there's 5 total, I believe, so don't get me wrong. But this one is about this clown that's going around venging the death of this little geeky kid killed by these drug dealers, and he has this ice cream truck. And the Killjoy movies, he also has like another dimension where a lot of things happen, and it takes place within his ice cream truck, and he can suck you into his dimension or his realm. But this one's cool. You can find this one streaming. The DVD's still cheap, but very much enjoyable Killjoy. Now, it's cheesy and it's low budget, but it's a whole lot of fun.
Michael! Come down here for a second, I need to talk to you.
What do you want from me?
You
You don't know how much I've been through in my life, Jada. From the time I've been kicked on, pushed on, spit on, bullied, you have no idea.
Well, I'll leave Jade alone, I swear.
That calls itself Killjoy. Only the love of a young woman can destroy the evil in the heart.
Next one is going to be It Chapter One. I was a huge fan of the original adaptations from the early 1990s by Tommy Lee Wallace. Just this one was just so amazing. The kids made it just a great cast of child actors that just made it fun. And it felt 80s, very authentic. And I just love a majority of this movie. Now, the Pennywise, it wasn't the worst thing in the world, but it's not necessarily the best. Tim Curry did a good job, and Bill Skarsgård didn't do that much of a shitty portrayal. But I'm not a fan of CGI, but definitely recommend It Chapter One.
There you go. She's all ready, Captain.
Thanks, Billy.
Been in before. People die or disappear 6 times the national average. And that's just grown-ups. Kids are worse. Way, way worse.
We all float down here.
I saw something. There was this
clown. Yeah, I saw him too.
It's all connected by the sewers. That's where it lives. What happened?
Before there was Terrifier, there was a short movie made by Damien Leone, probably butchering that last name, but he had this short called, I believe, Ninth Circle of Hell or something like that. And one of his first full-length feature movies was a movie called All Hallows Eve. And I remember seeing this way before the first Terrifier movie came out. Like, this was brand new to DVD. And I watched it, and I'm like, man, this is really cool. Everybody was all over the nuts of Pennywise. But I'm like, man, this Art the Clown is going to be a big deal. And look where we are today. So this one's definitely enjoyable. And it's an anthology film where Art the Clown shows up throughout different parts of this anthology, especially within the wraparound story. A majority of the original short is the last story from this movie, but it's just completely badass, and it's a great introduction to Art the Clown. You can find it on DVD, Blu-ray, and it's, I believe, it's streaming on Shudder right now. So, All Hallows Eve.
Babysitting on Halloween night? That's just asking for trouble.
Yeah, tell me about it. It's already been quite an eventful evening. Some creep slipped a videotape into Timmy's candy bag while we were trick-or-treating.
A videotape?
You should see what's on it.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm turning it off. It's too violent for the two of you.
Do you think that clown was real?
No, it's just make-believe. Demons, witches, monsters, that doesn't exist.
Please! The killer's out here! He's following me!
Who's following you?
He's a man. He's in a clown costume.
You got any mind?
This one is one of my favorite movies, and it's going to be Stitches. This, I believe, is an Irish-made movie with Ross Noble. He's a Irish comedian. I believe he's an Irish comedian, and it's directed by Conor McMahon. He hadn't done much, but I've loved all the movies that he directed so far. And I've talked about this in another video. What it is Ross Noble plays his birthday clown. He's kind of shitty at his job, but he goes to this house that's full of a bunch of little bastard children, and he ends up dead. Well, the little boy who has the birthday party, he wasn't the worst kid, but he has something to do with the death of Stitches. But he finally decides to have a birthday again several years later, and that brings back the spirit of Stitches the clown. This one's cool. I love horror comedies. It is just everything about it is fun. I definitely highly recommend this movie. Stitches is great. It's amazing. It's fun. It's funny. And it has a cool clown in it.
Everybody happy? Sniff 'em out.
One of the best movies ever made, and is going to be Killer Clowns from Outer Space. I talk about this movie a lot. I'm not going to give too much about it. It takes place in the 80s, and it's these alien clowns come out, and they want to feed. Everybody's seen this movie. But if you haven't, please stop what you're doing and check out Killer Clowns from Outer Space. Evan, what do you think about Killer Clowns from Outer Space?
I like it.
Who's your favorite clown?
Shorty.
Or just in general?
Shorty.
Shorty's your favorite clown throughout every clown in the world?
Shorty.
It was a night like any other night. Then something happened. something different.
It's no shooting star.
Why here? Why now? Why clowns? They've been knocking him dead all over the universe.
What are you gonna do? Knock my block off?
Soon they'll be doing it at a theater near you.
Killer clowns from outer space.
Pizza.
Maybe they're just cruising through the galaxy and stopped here for a bite to eat.
You don't need a police, pal. You need a psychiatrist. They want to play games? They're messing with the wrong guy.
What are you in for?
Killer clowns from outer space. It's crazy.
All right, two movies left. This one's quite controversial because of the backstory. Victor Salva is a huge piece of shit. He's a pedophile. Definitely have nothing for him except the swift ass kicking and some old Southern justice. But I'm not going to hold it against this movie, Clown House. I got to separate myself from him because this is actually a pretty fun movie. It's terrible what he did, and I'm so sorry that that ever happened to that child and any other children out there. But just in movie land, Clown House is a whole lot of fun. It's about these three brothers. It takes place around Halloween time, too. One of them's definitely afraid of clowns, and that's going to be our star, Casey, who is unfortunately the victim of Victor Salva. If you haven't heard about it, you can go ahead and read it. It's readily available on any information. And the fact that he did not have a long stay in prison just shows you what kind of... I'm rambling. Anyway, movie takes place about three brothers. There's these three psychos that break out of the mental asylum and they go straight for the carnival. They kill off the actual clowns, don their makeup and attire, and wreak havoc on these three boys at their house. It's just a cool, dark movie, and I'm not going to split hairs with all the other things. This movie is definitely out of print. It's very expensive, but you can find it on Amazon Prime streaming. So, Clown House.
If you've known what it is to be scared...
I bet you'll need someone to hold your hand.
I'm not afraid of the stupid circus, so shut up.
If you've imagined things that could shock you...
Maybe not the lions, huh, kids? The elephants.
Shut up!
You want to tell me why you really don't want to go tonight?
Chase. But what about those clowns?
If you ever wondered if your fears could come true.
Is Randy there yet?
What the hell is going on out there?
Then tonight, you'll know this place.
Trouble at the manor.
Where the crazy people live.
What the hell's going on? Maybe they try to break down. Maybe to go to the circus.
Some things that scare us are only imagined.
What out of it's gonna grab us, huh? Just because it's dark doesn't mean there's something awful in it.
It means you can't tell if there is.
Some of our darkest fears are only dreams. But sometimes the worst nightmares are for real. Clown House. The nightmare's over, but the fun has only just begun. We'll be right back.
tonight.
Who are?
The clowns.
In the very last movie on this list, like I say, it was in no particular order, has got to be House of a Thousand Corpses. I've absolutely loved this movie. Captain Spaulding is one of the greatest clowns in existence. Sid Haig was the absolute best. He was just amazing. He had the cool little gas station with all the fried chicken and madman and murder and whatnot. Rob Zombie's first film. Again, there's not much I could say about this one because this one's universally known. And if you haven't seen it, stop what you're doing and watch it. So, House of a Thousand Corpses.
Howdy, folks. You like blood, violence, freaks of nature?
On a stormy Halloween night, four young people set out across the back roads of America.
What's that? It's a hitchhiker.
What, should we stop?
We can't leave right here in the rain.
In search of a mysterious figure known only as
Dr. Satan.
You know anything about the legend of Dr. Satan?
Yeah, I can show you.
Dr. Satan! Ah, Dr. Satan!
What they uncovered.
Yeah, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Is the most horrifying and shocking tale of carnage ever seen.
Well, I bet you'd stick your head in the fire if I told you you could see hell.
You seen this girl?
Yeah, they wanted to play Nancy Drew with this local legend that people call Dr. Satan.
Stupid kids probably got themselves lost.
Let's get out of this nut house.
The boogeyman is real. And you found him.
It's showtime!
Please don't kill us.
From director Rob Zombie comes a journey into hell.
This can't be real. This can't be real. This can't be real.
House of a Thousand Corpses.
Hope you like what you see.
No!
All right, now let's talk about Terrifier 3. I'm going to give a little small, spoiler-free review. If you've seen Terrifier 1 and Terrifier 2 and All Hallows Eve, even though All Hallows Eve is its own thing, it has nothing to do with the story. So after the events of the first movie, it's 5 years later. Sienna goes live with some relatives, and she has an annoying-ass little cousin, but I'm going to leave her out of this. Her brother's trying to make the best of his life, going to college and doing him, and Art the Clown is pretty much just being Art the Clown. The gore in this movie is absolutely amazing. It's fun. I love gory depths and whatnot. Some can be a bit mean-spirited, but you got to kind of disconnect it. Yes, this is fake. But it wasn't a bad little movie. I kind of think that Art the Clown's kind of a little jackass because as soon as he has like a real threat, he pulls out a gun and switches the thing. And I'm a big thing about horror movie rules. So a little bit things here and there bother me, but overall it's fun. If you like the first one, which I think the first one was shit, part two was actually much better. And the third movie is on par with part two. So they go really good together. Same actors come back with the brother and sister. There's no little girl clown this time, which is cool because she didn't add too much of the character. We get Chris Jericho from AEW, WWE, and his band Fozzy. So he's fun in there. He plays a little orderly security guard in the asylum or whatever it is where the first victim's housed. It's definitely a good time. So I recommend go see that.
Thank you.
So thank you for tuning in to the last video store. I'm your host, Bud Haddonfield, Evan Haddonfield. I'm not that great at art, and I'm not artistic at all. But it was fun putting this stuff on. I'm definitely going to enjoy taking it off. So please like and subscribe. I hope you enjoy. We got a big Halloween episode coming. So sit back, go watch Terrifier 3 if you feel like it. It's not too bad. It's all the stuff about people throwing up and everything. Yes, it's gory, but it's things that's already been done before. And if you're a huge fan of the Art the Clown movies, the Terrifiers, go watch all of Adam Green's Hatchet movies. They're very on par, and they're just as enjoyable, if not more enjoyable. So please like and subscribe again. Tune in to further episodes. If there's something that you want me to cover, just drop a comment. I'm on Facebook, I'm on X, I'm on Instagram. I'm all over the place. So be safe and beware of clowns.
Michael Myers, all the heroes of my past, now the media is dying. Chucky and the zombies, now Olympic Cemetery. So bring me back those. I wanna come back to those times when all movies were so scary.